As far back as I can remember, The Simpsons has always been on television. I grew up watching it, and like many, it shaped my childhood. It was the type of show that seemed to attract everyone with its blend of animation, intelligence, humor, satire, heart, and countless references to both television film and cultural events. The Simpsons has aired well over 600 episodes, and is currently in the middle of its unprecedented 28th season. However, most fans and even creators of the show agree that the golden age of The Simpsons was from seasons 3 through 8. In that span, they had brilliant writers and directors collaborating on the show, such as Conan O'Brien, Brad Bird, Greg Daniels. They won 11 Emmy Awards, a Peabody Award, and averaged 18 to 22 million viewers per episode. In comparison, the most recent premiere of the 28th season pulled in only 3.36 million viewers. The golden age of The Simpsons was one classic episode after the next, filled with quotable lines and celebrity guests. But on September 28th, 1997, the golden age came to an end with season 9's second episode, The Principal and the Pauper.
I'm an imposter. That man is the real Seymour Skinner.
The controversial episode, which is based off of Jorge Borges' short story, The Improbable Imposter Tom Castro, gives us the backstory of Armin Tamzarian, who served in the army, befriended Sergeant Seymour Skinner, and then assumed his identity after Skinner presumably died in the war. The now infamous episode was almost universally panned upon its release. Series creator Matt Groening called it one of his least favorite episodes on the Season 9 DVD box set. And even Harry Shearer, the voice of Seymour Skinner and many, many others on the show, said this to the writers after having read the script. "That's so wrong. You're taking something that an audience has built 8 or 9 years of investment in and just tossed it in the trash can for no good reason. It's so arbitrary and gratuitous, and it's disrespectful to the audience." In an interview years later, Shearer added this in reference to the episode. "It's like punishing the audience for paying attention." And I think that's the biggest mistake the writing staff made with this episode. They completely misjudged the fans' adoration and commitment to the characters in the show. Here's a snippet from the episode's audio commentary found on the Season 9 DVD box set.
Skinner is what? He's a fine character,
you know,
but
what?
He's one of the, not one of the top eight.
Well, it's true that Skinner, but he is one of the top 10 characters.
Probably top 10.
And he's also like, he's one of our very favorite characters.
Oh, yeah, that's why we did this.
Doesn't it strike you as, I'm not criticizing people feeling that way. Doesn't it strike you as strange that you feel so strongly about Principal Skinner?
TV characters that you live with every week for many, many years become something that you have a closer relationship with.
I agree. I completely agree. And my question remains, isn't that strange?
Strange? Eliciting an emotional reaction from the audience because of their attachment and investment is what storytelling is all about. The fact that it's a cartoon doesn't change that. Moments like the beginning of Up or the ending of Toy Story 3 still resonate with audiences, regardless of the fact that they're animated. The audience will connect to the main characters no matter who or what they are, as long as the writers respect the characters too. That's the beautiful phenomena of television. We become so attached to the characters because we spend hours upon hours with them, watching them grow and develop over time. And after 8 years and 179 episodes, we grew attached to all the characters in The Simpsons, including Seymour Skinner. We watched him struggle to find meaning in his life after he'd been fired as the principal.
"Principal Skinner, I got car sick in your office."
And also watched him fall in love for the first time.
"I've got some menthol cigarettes."
"Oh, the heck with it."
To throw a wrench in the works and change Skinner's entire background is cheap, lazy, unearned drama. Like Harry Shearer said earlier, it's unfair to punish the audience for caring about the characters and investing in them. In my research for this essay, I rewatched The Principal and the Pauper, and I must say that the episode itself isn't as bad as I remember it. There are some genuinely funny moments.
"And why am I here?"
"Because the streets of Capital City are no place for 3 unescorted ladies."
"Why are the kids here?"
And beautiful animation throughout the episode. And if I'm being honest, I can't blame the writers entirely for trying something new. Besides a few refreshingly unique and heartfelt episodes sprinkled here or there, such as the episodes Holidays of Future Past and Barthood, The Simpsons has been out of fresh ideas for the past two decades. Homer has tried seemingly every job imaginable.
You know, I've had a lot of jobs. Boxer, mascot, astronaut, imitation Krusty, baby proofer, trucker, hippie, plow driver, food critic, conceptual artist, grease salesman, carny, mayor, grifter, bodyguard for the mayor, country western manager, garbage commissioner, mountain climber, farmer, inventor, smithers, poochie, celebrity assistant, power plant worker, fortune cookie writer, beer baron, quickie mart clerk, homophobe, and missionary. But protecting Springfield, that gives me the best feeling of all.
And the family has traveled all over the world. To this day, I still consider seasons 3 through 8 of The Simpsons my favorite span of television of all time. But unfortunately, I stopped watching The Simpsons years ago. I found it more depressing than anything, watching what I once considered to be the greatest show ever slowly reduced to a hollow shell over time. Out of the vast catalog of Simpsons episodes, The Principal and the Pauper is far from the worst, but I think the reason it sticks out in the minds of many fans and critics is because that episode definitively marked the end of a beloved show's historic run, its golden age. It was the day The Simpsons, as I like to remember it, died.